Why do most entrepreneurs fail? That's a good question. I believe most entrepreneurs fail because they start the business with the wrong reason and intent. Every single time I speak to a group of want-to-be entrepreneurs or entrepreneurs, and I ask them the question, how many of you want to start your own business? And a majority of the hands would go up, maybe 50, 60, 80%. Then I would ask them the next question, why? And usually I hear one of these three things. I want more money. I want to make more money, or I want more freedom, or the most common one is I want more time. Now, if you want to start your own business or you have the aspiration to start your own business because you want more time, comment below. Now, the problem with this is E-Myth. Michael Gerber talks about the book E-Myth. He said most entrepreneurs, they're actually not entrepreneurs, they are what we call employees suffering from an entrepreneurial seizure. And that's the E-Myth, entrepreneur myth. Meaning that one day they did something, their boss yelled at them, or they feel like they have a good idea, and they say, you know what, fuck this, I'm gonna start my own thing. They are employee with employee mentality and skill set, but they're suffering from an entrepreneurial seizure. Like, oh, no, I wanna do this, I'm gonna be my own thing. I'm gonna fire my boss and quit my job and do my own thing, right? If you wanna start a business because you want more time, let me tell you this. Starting a business because you want more time is as if you're saying, I want to have more time and have a baby. I want to have a baby and I have more time. It's not gonna happen. When you have a baby, don't you need to spend time taking care of the baby, making sure the baby stays alive, feeding the baby, nurturing and growing the baby? It's gonna take you more time, not less time, than what you're doing. A 9-to-5 job is much easier. 9-to-5, finish work, you go home, spend time with family, watch some TV, weekends, you don't think about work. As an entrepreneur, if you're an entrepreneur, you know exactly what I'm talking about. 24/7, we don't stop, we're always going. Even though when we are off, we're not really off now, are we? We're still thinking. When we are taking a shower, we're thinking about how to grow the business. What do we need to do? That's an entrepreneur. That's what we do. And most people, they start a business. Why they fail? Because they think they want more time. Now, when you get to a certain point, goes back to the baby analogy, when the baby grows up, you could have, you know, going to school and you can have your parents, your grandparents taking care of the baby, right? As the baby grows, become a teenager, adult, they will have a life on its own. Yes, they will take on life on its own. But in the first long period of time for years, guess what? You are taking care of the baby. It requires a tremendous amount of attention, love, and just nurturing to make that grow. It's exactly the same as business. It's no different. One of my students tell me, you know, Dan, if I make $5 million, I'm gonna call it quit. I said, you know what? That's exactly why you'll never make $5 million. And she's like shocked. What do you mean? That's exactly why you won't make $5 million. Why? Because you are thinking about getting to somewhere so you could quit. Successful people don't wake up one day and say, I'm gonna call it quit. The reason they're successful because they are good at what they do, they love what they do, they're very passionate about what they do. And that's why they're where they are today. If you want to get to somewhere, a destination, so that you can avoid something else, that is not gonna work. And that's why most entrepreneurs fail, because they start with that intent. Versus most entrepreneurs who are successful, most of them, they could call it quit, but they don't, because that's not how they operate. The reason, the very fact that you want to get to some place where you can call it quit is exactly why you got nothing that you could get to quit on. That's what I'm talking about. So you have to start with the right intent, start with the right motivation, and knowing that it's going to take some time. You're not going to get more time in the first 2, 3, 5, maybe even 10 years. Are you okay with that? Can you endure that frustration, the pain, the sacrifice? If not, then don't be an entrepreneur. Just go get a job, do something else. This is not your path. There are other ways to make money. You don't have to be an entrepreneur to make money. Don't be sold on the idea that, yes, I need to be an entrepreneur in order to be wealthy. Not necessary. It's not necessary. There are other ways to make money. If you have not watched my other videos, you can watch the ways to create income, the 5 ways to create more income. There are many ways to make money, not necessary through entrepreneurship. This is a This is not something that you do, this is something that who you are. It has to be in your blood, in your DNA, that you cannot sleep, that it bothers you, that you don't have, if you don't have that oomph, then you're not gonna make it as an entrepreneur.